Okay, so welcome to Edworthy Park in Calgary, Alberta. So I've actually attached the 360 camera to my head, but the idea here is I wanted to demonstrate that we can create 360 video or VR experiences and put them into, say, virtual reality headsets fairly easily. Now, this happens to be attached to my head. It would probably be a lot easier if I attach this to a stick to get a little bit further up off my head. So hopefully you're not looking at my hair. But the idea is that I'm able to go in and quite quickly, using fairly inexpensive cameras, and that's a relative thing, of course. But if you think about it, you can get a camera here, such as the GoPro Max, that could be shared by a school, could be shared by several classrooms. And then the content creation gives students the opportunity to create narratives of things that are important to them. So for example, this park, I live right near this park, it's quite important to me. And we're gonna go for a little walk in this video. We're gonna go down this trail. There's a beautiful lookout coming up where we'll be able to look over the river. And then we'll walk down a trail to go to a frozen waterfall, sort of. It is a frozen waterfall, but it's also the pathway. I think you'll find that interesting. But the idea here is, here in Edworthy Park, we have, this is Calgary, and we have a very unique city in that a lot of the waterfront along the Bow River is actually park and public land. So what we're able to do is we're able to take advantage of that and really have a beautiful pathway here, beautiful parkway that everybody can enjoy. And in a lot of cities, anything next to water is either privately owned or is condominiums, so it's owned by or it's inaccessible to most people. But not here in Calgary. Here in Calgary we have a massive park system, which by the way includes a lot of bike trails, and we can all enjoy that. So here, this is the lookout. I'm very fortunate, I live quite close to this park. So you can see down there we have the train tracks. That's a picnic area, and there's also a picnic area nestled in behind there. That's a pedestrian bridge. We have the parkway here, and if you look over to the other side, you can probably see that there's both a walking path as well as a cycle path. Calgary's full of cycle paths. That's a bad joke. But anyways, so there we have that. Again, this is fairly easy to film video. There is some editing tools out there, which I'll discuss. But for the most part, when we're dealing with virtual reality, a lot of what we see in our headsets when it comes to 360 video is action sports. And that's a lot of fun. We can have students enjoy things like roller coasters, or they can go on a safari. They can do things that are outside of their immediate vicinity. So they can be going to different geographic locations. But I think that part of learning is not just the consumption of things, but also the creation. So if we can find ways to allow students to tell their own stories and have their own voice and share that within a virtual reality environment, that becomes a very powerful way to not just learn topics, but also to exercise their creativity. So if there's a park near their house, or if there's something that's important to them, they could actually make that immersive video like I'm doing here and share that with others. That becomes their creative outlet. Like anything, it's a work in progress. Certainly it is for me. I'm very new to the world of 360 immersive videos. So you can see here that I think the biggest issue with my video here that I'm making, well, one, I'm going at night, so it's not nighttime, but it's definitely dusk. So you want to make sure that the conditions are nice for you. And the other thing that you can see here is that there's probably a lot of extra, I don't know until I see the video, but I'm guessing there's going to be a lot of extraneous video. Specifically, if you were to look down, you'd be seeing like the top of my head. So you'd be seeing the top of my head and my clothes and that sort of thing. But if you look up, which is what you should do, so look this way, and you'll be able to see the park, you'll be able to see the stairways, you'll be able to look behind me, and you'll be able to see the stairs that I'm coming down. So as I do more of this, hopefully I'll get better at eliminating some of the top of my head. And I'm thinking that would probably be accomplished by creating a little bit of elevation. So if I find maybe a backpack with a stick on it, and that's something you could also experiment with your students. So you can also give them that experience so that they can try things out. I guess a little bit about Edworthy Park. We're just coming down this pathway here. It's full of ice, so it is a little bit dangerous to come down here, but I do have on my shoes, I have crampons. So that's at least digging into the ice so that I'm not slipping terribly. And around the corner here, we have something pretty exciting. I think you'll enjoy this. So Edworthy Park, Calgary, Alberta, Canada. And this is what I wanted to come down and show you. This is, I think this just looks cool. I'll stop here, but you can see here we have the water has flowed down here. And you can see that it is frozen into a cool pathway. This is definitely where I want to make sure I have spikes in my shoes.